California Quake 14. Without question, Denise Loden, the leader of the Sundogs, take a look, looking absolutely exhausted, and well, she should, and I'm not sure just exactly what Richard Vaughn is thinking, but one thing I do know, Mark D'Amato and the enforcers are waiting in the wings. The cameras are on the starting line. The referee has got the blockers behind them. We are all set to start the fourth period, and we are underway. And right off the bat, it is Sam Martin breaking up for the Sundogs. This is Brian Gallagher for the California Quakes. Gallagher, the most physical of the two. Martin, certainly the faster. Gallagher taking it out, taking a look. The big elbow. Martin bounces right off the railing. And now it's Brian Gallagher all by himself closing on the pack. And right now, the Sundogs trail by 11 points. Rather, the Quakes trail by 11 points. They need it. Now the double blocking set up by Marshall and David Gladdy. And into the railing goes Gallagher. But there's the Superman from John Atkinson. He busts up that double block. Already 2 points for Gallagher. And now he cuts off the jam.
And Brian Gallagher, you saw him after Sam the Flame Martin hit the ground pointing to himself. That's typical Quake fashion. Celebrated. It's a good shot. I was celebrating earlier. Here's the replay with the double block being set up by Gleddy and Sean Marshall. Here comes the Superman, Big Sean Atkinson, paving the way for his teammate, Brian Gallagher, scores the point, calls off the jam.
There's a look at the enigma for the Florida Sundogs, the coach, Little Richard. Let's see what he's up to. Breaking out for the California Quakes is Stan Vaughn. Here comes Tom Smith for the Florida Sundogs. This is Vaughn. Look, but coming up behind is the white pony. There's Eric Grimley. Tom Smith now being sandwiched between two of the California Quakes. Stan Vaughn's brother now slowly comes around, and down goes Smith. And now it's two California Quakes breaking in on the pack.
And that was a classic version of somewhere Tom Smith didn't want to be, and the Quakes took full advantage of two against one.
Little now back, but man possessed some great blocking, but yet Smith goes, Dan Vaughn goes right by him. Little Richard, I don't know about him. Sean Atkinson has done a tremendous job of baiting him, but right there, Atkinson goes down. Now here comes Bobby Saleen. Now remember, Dan Vaughn has already left the pass once. The California Quakes picking up some valid points, and now the jam is pulled off, but a great big jam. A ton of points, in fact, 8 big points for the California Quakes.
And I tell you, you see Richard Brown right there holding his side. It's been a story we talked about all day. Sean Atkinson planning before the game he was going to get Richard Brown out of his niceties and get him into a fist fight. You have to wonder how long Richard Brown will be able to keep his cool and not let Sean Atkinson get under his skin.
I would have to wonder, knowing his 37 years of experience, the middle Richard Brown perhaps be playing possum. But nonetheless, tremendous credit. The California Quakes were down by 11. They now trail by only one. And the surprising part, Sean Atkinson so far has been very quiet in this comeback. Now breaking out to the Sam the Flame Martin. And coming out here quickly for the California Quakes. The recipient of that whip, this is Martin Grimley. A tremendous job of closing that with everyone thought to be an insurmountable lead. And now down goes Grimley, an elbow from Sam Martin. We talked about how Martin played so very much. Punching the lead back. He has not left the field. He's about to give Sam Martin the whip. The lead lane back. Now there's Sean Atkinson hammering away at Sam Martin. Punching the lead coming up. Perhaps to try to take on Atkinson. And that's exactly what happens. Into the rail and over goes Punching the lead. Now Sam Martin. Classic Texas Bulldog. Where are you, Brock Nathlandsville?
trying to think of what's going through a mind like Richard Brown's, but I know one thing. His teammates are furious with him. What was a big lead is now down to 1 point. Let's go back. Back ties at 10 and half.
After the ejection of the fight, the referee starting to pack from the starting line. Right off his flag. Yeah, they're coming out of here. Got the Posse Saline. Sam Martin also up for the Sundogs. Right now it's Gallagher and Posse Saline. And here goes Sam Martin right over the railing and out onto the track. Martin is down. Here comes Posse Saline. Brian Gallagher closing on us. This is Gallagher and Saline. They just went by Sam Martin. Brian Gallagher has picked up 1 point already. We are all down at 25. Posse Saline goes into the railing. Here comes Gallagher. There's Sean Atkinson Lee waiting to help his teammate. Remember, we're dead even at 25. Sean Atkinson out taking a beat on David Lennie. Down goes the Gator wrestler. Gallagher goes over for him. The quick take the lead, 26-25. And Gallagher comes off the jam. Unbelievable. The California Quake coming back from an 11-point deficit. And now Sean Atkinson going after Posse Saline. It's not getting Saline. The Quake is pulling down. The Quake right now with the advantage. And it looks like it. It could have been great.
And what a win for the Quake. 26-25. Sean Atkinson can celebrate, but wait a minute. Looks like Mark D'Amato has come out of the stands, out of the seats, and he's yelling at Atkinson. So not much time for Atkinson to celebrate before D'Amato gets in his face. Of course, D'Amato of the New York Enforcers is there to scout him. Oh, man. He reaches up and gives Sean Atkinson a shot. So he wasn't exactly a passive observer, and Atkinson doesn't much like that, does he? Looks like Atkinson, Atkinson and D'Amato are going to go at it. Look at D'Amato standing there in his street clothes. Atkinson is still on skates, and D'Amato has less street clothes on now as Atkinson rips off of his shirt. Wow. When these two teams get together on the track, that's really going to be something. Atkinson and D'Amato being separated, and hopefully some peace will be restored. The Quake will still be happy with the win. The Sun Dogs will be upset about the loss. The Bond Squad celebrates the victory, but on the other side of the coin, Denise Loden and the Sun Dogs are upset. She's mad that Richard Brown pretty much abandoned his game plan and was haunted by Atkinson. Let's go down now to Broadway. Danny Wolf, he's with Sean.
Tremendous come-from-behind victory for your Quake tonight, Sean Atkinson. Evidently, your little plan on Richard Brown worked.
Oh, yeah, he's a time bomb ready to take. Bam, he blows up, man. I'm telling you right now. I knew what would happen. Same with Mark D'Amato. Peanut head, man. He's next. He is next. It's all mind game. Started right now, baby. Oh, Daddy, what you going to do when the architect comes for you?
Look at this play, baby. You started what you had. That's right. He ain't going to come back for no more.
Well, you talk about inspiration. No wonder Sean Atkinson's in such a good mood all the time. But he should be in a good mood tonight because his California Quakes have come from behind. They were 11 points down, an exciting victory. The Quakes get there and win it by one. As for the Florida Sun Dogs, they'll just go back and regroup and try and be ready for the next game. We hope you've enjoyed this one. It's been a terrific game. For Lee Hawk Rearman, for Ken Resnick, for Broadway Danny Wolf, I'm Rory Marcus. We'll see you next week.